history repeats itself, but it is too fast. Last year we had one wave of COVID eating us, and this year again the second wave is here. Last year we had lockdown and things were much under control. This year we don't have lockdown across India, but majority of the cities are getting into lockdown mode and the numbers have been gigantic big. So last year we were in thousands, this year we are in lakhs. Every day we are crossing more than a lakh numbers, so that's alarming. Market has also taken a hit because of COVID, and thanks to the markets going down, we have opportunity for us to look at very good stocks and start investing into it. So the markets today, Sensex went down by 1707.94 points and Nifty went down by 524.10 points thanks to COVID, plus the global cues because of which the markets had to go down. Financial sector stocks are the major ones which got hit today. Probably moratorium and other things is what is coming in picture, and this is what the sentiments is leading towards, because of which a lot of people have started selling stocks in this particular sector. Let's wait and watch. Apart from this, the day's news: Flipkart ties up with Adani for creating infrastructure, that is a fulfillment center, which would be approximately around 5,34,000 square feet in Mumbai. Plus they are planning to make a data center, with Adani will build it and lease it out to Flipkart. And this happens, it's one of its kind center in Mumbai which Flipkart plans to use. Tata also comes out with an ambitious plan wherein they want to replicate model of Alibaba, and they are in talks with a company, Indian based company called IndiaMart, and if this goes through, there could be a possible alliance between both of them, and they will be replicating it using all the latest technologies and the bandwidth or the clientele that IndiaMart has. This is one of the good things. Let's wait and watch. Apart from this, Future Retail may get 2 years relief on the loan repayment thanks to the COVID situation. The people who have invested or given debts to this particular company are considering on recast of the debts, based upon which they would give them time of 2 years, and then probably they'll get them to pay the balance amount. So this is what is the latest news. Apart from this, Amazon India launches a mentor program for startups and emerging brands, wherein they want to tap the potential that we as Indians have in the business space. So they have a particular program called Amazon Sambhav, which will be happening between 15th to 18th April. So a lot of these startups can go online and register themselves and probably pitch in your ideas. And if your idea has been selected, you may get funding or the kind of assistance that is required with regard to technology. Apart from this, the other thing is Clubhouse, who also came in news, just like how LinkedIn came in news 2 days back, wherein a company called Cyber News, which is again a magazine, told that 1.3 million users' data is being sold online or is being available online. They are telling that it's not happened. So let's wait and watch if this comes to be true or this is false. The top gainer for the day is Dr. Reddy's, thanks to government giving approval to the Sputnik vaccination from Russia, wherein Dr. Reddy's is the one who will be manufacturing it in India. This is one of the good news that happened. And the biggest loser for the day was Tata Motors, which went down by almost 10%, and the same closed at 286.55 paise. I would recommend you to look at Tata Motors more carefully, because they have been getting very good market response and they have been capturing the market. They are right now the third largest player in the market, and this is an opportunity for you to pick up the shares at a discounted price. 10% downward movement and 286 is actually a very lucrative price for you to look at this particular company. I would recommend you to keep an eye on this particular company and start buying it in bits and pieces. As and when you see that price keep going down, you can start buying more. Gold today has gone up by 137 rupees for every 10 grams, and the same is trading at 46,730 rupees. Silver also has gone up by 223 rupees for every 1 kilo, and the same is trading at 67,206. Dollar and euro both have gone up. Dollar is trading at 76 rupees 36 paise, and the same is up by 3 paise. Euro also has gone up and it's trading at 89 rupees 59 paise, and the same is also up by 63 paise. There is no change in petrol and diesel prices, but globally the crude oil prices have been coming down thanks to the uncertainty and the lockdown that's happening across the world. The crude is actually going down, but in India they are taking their own time to reduce the prices. So let's wait and watch. The technical charts, I don't have to be surprised. It is not showing us any clear direction, but there is weakness in the market. So I would recommend you to look at the market more carefully and observe companies which you feel may be of good business, you can invest into it. Thank you. Have a great day. Do like and subscribe the channel and share the videos amongst your friends so that more people get to learn and earn. Thank you.